What's up, world? Welcome back to another episode of Clark Crew Reviews. It's your boy, Donovan. I got another little late night session going on. If you are one of my 836 subscribers, you would know that I do that from time to time. I'm a night owl, as some people close to me tend to call me, but it is what it is. What I'm going to do, I'm going to do a review of the most recent Godzilla King of the Monsters TV spot. Okay, did a couple of these. I told myself I wasn't going to do them because really nobody gives a shit. But if I'm going to be a real YouTube reviewer, why not, right? Who cares if anybody listens? I'm doing this because I enjoy it. But anywho, I'm trying something different, which is a program I use to do my videos. So if it's not as smooth with the transitions as my usual videos, please forgive your boy. So here we go, right? You might hear some clicking too, because I'm clicking through some stuff to make sure I get to the right scenes, whatever you want to call it. So, but as you can see, got a different camera. Let me straighten it up a little bit so you can look at me. So with the first scene in the trailer, right, you get this, the same monster that you've been getting coming out the mount, and everybody has their suspicions, but nobody knows what the hell the monster is called coming out of the mountain. Some people think it's Anguirus, some people think it's whoever else. I have no idea who the hell this monster is. I'm more curious about how he relates to the story. Is he an early foe for Godzilla to come out and test his wit against? Does he go against somebody else, or is he just woken up and he goes wandering among the mountains that it come out of? You know what I mean? I don't know. I don't know who it is. I don't know his purpose. So this guy, some people think it's the giant spider. Can't remember his name at all. Can't remember the name, but some people think this is a giant spider, even though those legs look like crab legs. So then in the trailer, they do a lot of talking about, like, you know, we gotta help Godzilla, Godzilla's on our side. They make Godzilla sound like a true protagonist. You get shots of possibly when they're in Antarctica, when Ghidorah wakes up. You get shots in Boston at Midway when Ghidorah is rampaging. But this was in the first trailer, if I'm not mistaken, and it's Millie Bobby Brown's character looking out this giant ass window and seeing this giant ass eyeball looking back at her belonging to one of King Ghidorah's heads. Now, I don't know about her, but if it was me, I would be shitting myself a little bit. I mean, who wouldn't? A giant monster looking at you? You know what I mean? And you see how I'm so used to looking at the other camera? I keep looking up like this, knowing the camera's right here, because I had to change scenes with it. So, my bad. You actually get this beautiful shot of Rodan. Now, I gotta say that the design of Rodan has grown on me. It kind of grew on me like Jared Leto's Joker in Suicide Squad, right? You know, I like my comic book movies. But at first when I was seeing this, I was like, it doesn't look like a pterodactyl, a Pteranodon, nothing like that. It looks like a Hulk, an eagle, a vulture because of that beak. But the more I look at it, the more shots I get, he looks prehistoric. Now, he's massive. He's huge. He's taking this machine gun to the face like a boss without even flinching. But I'm starting to really like how his design looks. I am. The theory is, the fan theory, because a lot of these shots you see, Rodan chasing these jets, or there's a jet from Monarch, and there's this theory that they're trying to lure him to Ghidorah. And then you get a few more seconds of the original shot where they show these two colliding of Rodan and Ghidorah attacking each other. Now, I played a lot of sports in my life, right? And I know a little something about momentum. And if you look at this shot, it looks like Rodan tackled Ghidorah. He actually, if you watch this trailer, they collide and he takes his momentum into Ghidorah, throwing him back a little bit. Look, Rodan's on top of Ghidorah. So it looks like he has the upper hand. Now, somebody with vast Godzilla knowledge as myself, and I've been a Godzilla fan for a long time, You can ask my mama about that. Rodan's not going to win. Rodan has never single-handedly beat Ghidorah, ever. I don't think Ghidorah's ever single-handedly been defeated by anybody. Maybe Godzilla one time. I don't remember the movie. I'm sure somebody will correct me in the comment section down below, but Rodan's not the one. But I imagine that Rodan loses and either dies or submits, because Ghidorah is, all three heads are screaming for victory on top of the mountain that Rodan came out of. How do I know that? From this gorgeous shot right here. I actually took this myself from watching the trailer. I probably shouldn't say that because it's going to give me a copyright violation on here. But at first when I did it, my reaction with my son, I was like, what do they think? Ghidorah is the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? But no. Watching some other reactions, thinking about it a little bit more, caught it beautifully with that lightning strike too. He's standing on top of molten lava, unfazed, and they have the him in the background and the cross in the foreground. I think they're using that as a contrast between, you know, the good, which is the cross, and the devil, which is Ghidorah, a destructive, devilish serpent, Hydra. Just a theory, but I mean, it's not unique, but I kind of agree with it. Something else to take note is that if you look on the Monarch website, that they talk about, how fast Rodan can fly. And as you can see, these two poor individuals are about to get blown away like it's an F5 hurricane coming through the town. I think it's a Hispanic island he's on. It's made up, but I would imagine from the naming, it's Hispanic residents or Latino. But this soldier is holding on for dear life. But you gotta have some strength. If he's blown away like that, you gotta have some strength to hold on to that pillar. So kudos to him. But those two people are getting blown away. And I would imagine, for morality, the kid's gonna get saved. But I bet you the guy on the left's gonna fly away something vicious. One other thing that everybody else is pointing out is that they're not sure if this is Mothra's end. If Mothra's sacrificing herself, which will be her end, or she's just taking a blast in mid-battle. But there's no way in hell that Mothra can fight Ghidorah to any type of success. I don't care what anybody says, it's not happening. You can have all the god rays you want. Now, as you see, it looks like an eyeball on the wing. In case you didn't know, the director said he wanted to show a connection between the Queen of the Monsters and the King of the Monsters, so he put Godzilla's eyes on Mothra's gigantic wings, which they look sweet, but Mothra's about to take a full face blast of Ghidorah's gravity beams, which she does in the trailer if you watch it. It just looks like it destroys her. One thing that nobody's pointed out from the other videos I watched is that the edge of these wings right here, they look singed. They don't look like that in previous images. So this is a battle-worn Mothra. That's my takeaway. Looks like she's been through some, she's got some damage to her because the end of those wings are burnt up. You ever seen a moth fly into a flame? That's what the wings look like right there. She looked like she's on her last leg. Something weird and something that I've never seen before is, and I thought this, I didn't think about it until afterwards. A human character is actually getting hand to nose contact with Godzilla. Like he's touching Godzilla, calling him beautiful. I do not recall anybody in any Godzilla movie having this type of contact with the king. I haven't seen it. So this is something different for your boy in any media whatsoever. I haven't seen it. So it just kind of blew my mind. It was a little different. Maybe over the top sentimental. Maybe they're making Godzilla a little too much on the side of mankind. But I have to see the full story play out to kind of give you a real answer. And then you see the quick shot of these battleships with the planes in the background, strolling side by side with Gojira, I'm guessing, to Boston for the final battle. This shot was unique because Godzilla's leaning in for a sniff of the crew. I don't know what's going on. Maybe he's acknowledging their help. Maybe they're using, because I guess for some device they're using to communicate with the monsters. Maybe this is a moment where they're asking for help. Or maybe this is when Godzilla get freed, because they talked about earlier in the trailer Godzilla being freed. So I don't know, but his neck looked extra long. But look, he's massive though. Jesus. And then I watched this like 18 times. Because this looks like it's a point of view of the Monarch jet flying towards Boston, which is the final fight scene once again. But I was trying to see if in the background it was two monsters fighting, but it more or less looks like they're flying along, probably with Godzilla. Ghidorah is destroying everything, and they're leading the way for Godzilla to take that nigga down. So everything's getting destroyed. Everything's finna get destroyed. And there's gonna be a lot of casualties. So maybe Man of Steel level casualties, you know what I mean? But it's a good shot, dude. It's a unique shot. Here's my thing, okay? This Godzilla is gonna be scenic, beautiful. There's gonna be a lot of money shots. It's gonna be a CGI fest. So if you don't like that, this ain't gonna be the movie for you. But I have a feeling that as a Godzilla fan, it is gonna be the best looking, most entertaining, most action-packed Godzilla movie ever created. Like I said, as a fan, I beg so, I hope so. It doesn't have to have a great story. It just has to have a story that makes sense and is coherent and it flows. But guys, I think we're in for a real treat. I've gotten a lot of love on my other two reaction videos with my son. If you guys enjoyed my breakdown of Godzilla King of the Monsters, please let me know in the comment section down below. While you're here, like, share, and subscribe to your boy's channel. If I get a notification that you subscribe to me and you're excited for Godzilla, I'll subscribe back to you. Until next time, y'all take it easy. Game recognized game. Peace.